Dear students, today we are going to study how to prove the irrationality of numbers. Proving irrationality of numbers. First, let us revise irrational numbers. A number S is called irrational if it cannot be written in the form of P by Q, where P and Q are integers and Q not equal to 0. Examples, root 2, root 3, root 5, etc. Now, how can we prove that these numbers are irrational? For that, we will use one theorem. Theorem states, let P be a prime number. If P divides A square, then P divides A, where A is a positive integer. I will use numbers to explain this theorem. If 9 square is divisible by 3, then 9 is also divisible by 3. This is the simple explanation of this theorem. I hope that now it is clear to you. To prove the irrationality of numbers, we use the method of contradiction. How do we apply contradiction method here? Example, to prove root 2 is irrational, we assume that root 2 is rational. Opposite of irrational is rational. Or to prove root 3 is irrational, we assume that root 3 is rational. Opposite of irrational is rational. Now, let us take an example. Prove that root 2 is irrational. First step, let us assume to the contrary, root 2 is rational. Now we know that every rational number can be written in the form of A by B. So here also we write root 2 in the form of A by B. That is, root 2 is equal to A upon B, where A and B are coprimes. What are coprimes? Coprimes are numbers which do not have common factors other than 1. So here, A and B do not have any common factor other than 1. Cross multiplying, we get root 2B is equal to A. Squaring on both sides, we get 2B square is equal to A square, equation number 1. This means A square is divisible by 2. According to the theorem, A is also divisible by 2. Or we can say A is a multiple of 2. So we can write A is equal to 2C for some integer C. Now, substitute the value of A in equation number 1. We get 2b square is equal to 2c the whole square. That is, 2b square is equal to 4c square. That is, b square is equal to 2c square. This means b square is divisible by 2. And so, b is also divisible by 2. Therefore, A and B have at least 2 as a common factor. But this contradicts the fact that A and B are coprime. Thus, our assumption is wrong that root 2 is rational. Hence, root 2 is irrational. Let us do the third exercise of this chapter. Prove that root 5 is irrational. Let us assume that, to the contrary, root 5 is rational. So we can write root 5 is equal to A upon B, where A and B are coprime. Cross multiply. Root 5B is equal to A. Squaring on both sides, we get 5B square is equal to A square. Equation number 1. This means A square is divisible by 5. So, A is also divisible by 5. So, we can write A is equal to 5C for some integer C. Substituting the value of A in equation number 1, we get 5B square is equal to 5C the whole square. That is, B square is equal to 5C square. Means, B square is divisible by 5. So, B is also divisible by 5. Thus, A and B have at least 5 as a common factor. But, this contradicts the fact that A and B have no common factors other than 1. Thus, our assumption is wrong that root 5 is rational. Hence, root 5 is irrational. Prove that 3 plus 2 root 5 is irrational. In class 9, you have studied the sum or difference of a rational number and an irrational number is irrational. Here 3 is a rational number and 2 root 5 is an irrational number. So we will prove that the sum of 3 and 2 root 5 is irrational. Let us assume 3 plus 2 root 5 is rational. So we can write 3 plus 2 root 5 as A upon B, where A and B are coprimes. Rearranging, we get 2 root 5 is equal to A upon B minus 3. That is, root 5 is equal to 1 upon 2 into A upon B minus 3. Now you look at the right hand side of this equation. A and B are integers. So we can say that 1 upon 2 into A upon B minus 3 is a rational number. Therefore, root 5 is also a rational number, but this contradicts the fact that root 5 is irrational. So we conclude that 3 plus 2 root 5 is irrational. Prove that the following are irrationals. First one, prove that 1 by root 2 is irrational. Let us assume that 1 by root 2 is rational. So we can find coprime A and B such that 1 upon root 2 is equal to A upon B. Rearranging, we get root 2 is equal to B upon A. Since A and B are integers, B upon A is a rational number. Thus, root 2 is a rational number, which contradicts the fact that root 2 is irrational. Hence, we can conclude that 1 by root 2 is irrational. Next one, prove that 6 plus root 2 is irrational. Let us assume that 6 plus root 2 is a rational number. So we can write 6 plus root 2 is equal to A upon B, where A and B are coprimes. Rearranging, we get root 2 is equal to A upon B minus 6. Since A and B are integers, A upon B minus 6 is a rational number. And therefore, root 2 is rational. This contradicts the fact that root 2 is irrational number. Hence, we can conclude that 6 plus root 2 is irrational. Finally, questions for practice. Show that 5 minus root 3 is irrational. Second one, show that 3 root 2 is irrational.